Man, it is super cool to be back in this elite world. 9 months ago, I didn't think this was even possible. I've worked so hard to reach this moment right now. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm trying really hard to love myself again. And with that said, I think the smartest thing for me to do is retire.
What?
I was abusing pain medication. I had a huge pain pill problem. I was getting pills illegally because that's how many I was taking. And sure enough, I got busted. I was being a very selfish person. I got arrested for drugs back in 2009. I got arrested for drinking in 2018. Jail, man, was, scared the living hell out of me. Talk about hitting rock bottom. My mind is going crazy with thoughts and, you know, the good and the bad, the right and the wrong. I'd messed up, you know, like big time. And that I couldn't live my life like this. Like, I knew I had a problem.
Yo, right now,
oh, wow. Right off the bat, it's gonna be a death drop.
He's gonna play again.
Got him, great. Wow, God. Come here to the match. And still, TNA.
Tough deal because, you know, he was slowly deteriorating as the day went by. And like Eric said, you didn't know how bad it was until you got into the ring. And it was not good. Not good for wrestling, not good for the fans, not good for Jeff, not good for anybody.
I agree, ladies and gentlemen, at this point, let's go.
And
let's revisit
just kind of a shame.
Has gone down tonight here at Victory Road.
I felt like I was kind of losing myself.
Here's the thing, Matt. You're starting to make your brother sound like the sober one.
You know, there was a point where he was with WWE, and when he first got arrested for these issues, and he did go to rehab, it was for like 30 days or something, and he did that, and it was a stint, and that helped him out a lot, but it was also at a very bad time in his life, because our dad was like sick and literally like on his deathbed, you know, so it was, I think it was hard for Jeff to really focus like he should have then. And what do I need to do to make Jeff Hardy better? What do I need to do to correct this? To be better for my family, to be better for my daughters.
I didn't want my daughters to, you know, see me ever like that, ever again. My mother would have been extremely disappointed, and I know she helped me through my deal. That's a fact as far as I'm concerned.
He has had so many addiction problems through the years, but he's never like been this specific and never in detail tried to work through it so much, and he spent all his time and energy on that, and that's where I can see the biggest difference in my brother.
I got a lot of making up to do, and I will. Wrestling is still an outlet for me creatively. It's the way I express myself best, I think. I just want to be the best I can and stay on this role that I'm on and do it for as long as I can. Pro wrestling to me is an art form, and it forever will be. The only thing that limits you is your imagination. That's probably the scariest thing for the fans watching me, because sometimes my thoughts are too big for my size. Myself in situations that scare me, just to conquer them.
Oh my God, a shot, but a spear. Oh my God, it was a twist of fate. Hit the ladder, Jeff. No. Jeff Hardy said he was going to steal WrestleMania. Oh my God.
There's a little fear, but you know, that's part of the fun. If there was no fear, there's no, you know, tremendous payoff in it all, because fear is part of the fun.
Oh my God!
God! Jeff Hardy from 20 feet in the air!
I have a limit. I'm not exactly sure what that is, but there's definitely a line drawn. But the thing is, when you get out there and the adrenaline starts flowing, I tend to forget all that and forget that I am limited in what I do, because their energy is superhuman to me. You can't beat that, man. When you hear that reaction, you don't just hear it, you feel it. The goosebumps were taking me over. I felt like I was supposed to be there.
Prevail.